In Unity, avatars are definitions that tell the animation system how to animate the transforms of a model. For humanoid models, these can be configured to your own specifications. When you select a mesh in the project panel, the inspector will have three tabs: Model, Rig, and Animations. To configure the avatar, click the Rig tab. For this tutorial, we're assuming that the model is a humanoid. As such, the animation type should be humanoid. Below that is the avatar definition property. The options are Create from this model and Copy from other avatar. Copy from other avatar simply copies an avatar definition from one that has already been configured. In most cases, Unity will be able to configure your model automatically, in which case, you will see a tick mark next to the Configure button. Otherwise, it can be configured manually. We will discuss configuring an avatar manually in just a moment, but first, let's finish talking about the Rig tab, specifically the Optimize Game Objects checkbox. By default, Unity does not optimize model rigging. What that means is that Unity will create many empty game objects to represent all of the model's bones and joints. This gives you access to the transforms of all of the model's parts, but it is much less efficient. In most cases, you will not need this level of control. Therefore, it is recommended to check Optimize Game Objects. By checking this box, Unity will not create extra empty game objects. Obviously, not managing all of those transforms will improve the performance of your game. However, under some circumstances, we might want to reference a particular part of a model in code or in the hierarchy. We might, for example, want to add a cup of coffee to the hand of the model. We can still complete this in an optimized model by exposing the transforms we want. To expose a transform, click the plus sign under the Extra Transforms to Expose box. Then simply drill down and find the transform you want. In this case, we will drill down to find the model's right hand. If you change the optimization of a model, you will need to reconfigure the avatar definition afterwards. To do this, click on the Configure button. You will be asked if you want to keep the unapplied import settings you have made to the model. Choose Apply to keep your changes. If you have unsaved changes to your scene, Unity will also ask if you want to save them because configuring an avatar is done in another scene. The configuration scene is empty apart from our model with its entire hierarchy exposed. The inspector has two tabs, Mapping and Muscles. First, we will discuss mapping. This is the mapping of the model's imported hierarchy to Unity's definition for how a humanoid should be laid out. Immediately below the tabs is a representation of the humanoid model with various circles and dots. These represent the bones of the model. Ones that are circled with a dotted line are optional and are not necessary for the definition. On the diagram, you can select which part of the model you are looking at: the body, head, or either hand by clicking the buttons on the left side. Below the diagram is a list of all of the bones organized by section, with the transform that has been applied to that bone. In order to apply a transform to a bone, you can either drag the transform from the hierarchy to the dots on the diagram, the specific property below the diagram, or you can use the circle select button. Below the list of bones are two drop-down menus, Mapping and Pose. Mapping has four options: Clear, Auto Map, Load, and Save. Clear will remove all of the bone allocations. AutoMap will get Unity to try and fit the correct transforms to their bones. Generally, this is the best approach to start with when configuring an avatar. Load and Save are for dealing with humanoid templates so you can use configurations across multiple avatars. These are generally not required as Unity will usually be able to AutoMap your avatar. The Pose dropdown has three options: Reset, Sample Bind Pose, and Enforce T-Pose. Reset removes any pose from the avatar and sets it to its default, Sample Bind Pose tries to set the avatar to the pose in which it was modeled. And Force T Pose sets the avatar into a T pose. This is the way that Unity prefers to deal with avatars. When you have finished mapping, it is best to set the avatar into a T pose. When you have finished mapping your avatar's bones, click Apply to keep the changes, then click on the Muscles tab to deal with the model's muscles. If you have unapplied import settings, Unity will ask if you wish to apply them. Under the Muscles tab are three groups of settings. The first group is just for previewing the overall range of movement of the avatar. And if you're going to adjust any of the muscle ranges, it is best to leave these at their default by clicking the Reset All button. The second group of settings are the Per Muscle settings. These are grouped by body areas, and each one takes the form of a slider, which can be used to adjust the range of muscle movement. The numbers range between negative 180 and 180, representing the number of degrees of movement around that axis. The third section is for additional settings. The twist settings are how much of the twist affects the neighboring joints. The stretch settings are for how much the bones can stretch when the avatar is retargeted to another model. Finally, the feet spacing is the default distance between the feet. You can use this to affect things like walking animations. Once you have set the muscles as you like, you can apply your changes and press Done to return to your scene.